Hey guys, welcome back. All right, so today it's Easter time, so I think I'm gonna start painting an empty tomb. I've never painted a tomb before.
This is the first time.
Sharpening up the pencil here. All right, so I am looking at a reference off to the side, just give me an idea of what I'm doing. And I'm gonna start off with a drawing. And I'm kinda, when I hold the pencil, I'm sort of holding it like this, rather than like drawing with a pencil. I'm holding it like I'm gonna apply it at an angle. So, I would put the corner of the tomb here, and it's gonna come up a little bit, come over here, and then down, and then come across straight like that. This one comes over in this direction, and then you have this edge of the tomb, side of the tomb. The good thing about this, it doesn't have to be perfect, obviously, because it's a tomb, so who's to say what a tomb looks like? Here you have some different colors and some greens and some grays. Eventually I'll put in there. Okay, so now the opening of the tomb would be, let me think here, like right here. And this will come down. So that's where you can look into the tomb that's open. And then this might come at an angle that way. There's a step right about here I'll put in. And that comes straight down. And this is this side of the step. And it keeps coming. This goes, let me think here. This goes straight across to about here. It continues that way. And we just get the basic exterior drawn in first. There's a big rock right here. Comes up there, and there's another little rock there. There's a rock. Goes down like that. Then you can see the edge of it, like there. Rock right there. This kind of comes down this way, and oops, that comes down to there, and then there's some stuff down here, rocks and whatever. Just trying to think here where I'm going here. There's a rock right up here. There's a rock that goes down, that goes that way. Rocks here. There's a rock right here. A little thinner there. And let me see how this guy comes out in front a little bit more. Now you have the big stone. Right in here. Try to make it as round as possible. Goes behind over here and down there. So it's like right behind that. And then I think I need to pull this over a little bit this way. You can see the edge of the stone gives a little bit of thickness. I'm just going to be pure black in here. So you have the main stones, and there's another kind of round stone over here. You have some greenery and some greens growing in there. This gives a little bit of an angle here. And some larger stone formations. Different stone formations. All right, so I think we have a pretty decent outline of it. There's a, it's like a wedge right here, where the stone's gonna go like along this path. Let me pull this down a little bit here. There's a wedge right here. So I sharpen the pencil a little. Just kind of put in some dark in here. I'm gonna paint that in anyway. Just gonna get a feel for what's gonna happen. Actually, I might even start painting there. Maybe I pull this over a little in this direction. All right, so I think we have a pretty good drawing in. Now I need a palette. Let me go grab a palette. Palette, aka plate, paper plate. And I'll start painting this in black. I'll just go straight black, a little brown, raw umber, just to flavor it slightly. I want straight black, but close to black. So I think I'm just going to start painting in the empty area there. The open area. Put in about 50% burnt umber, 50% black. Painting this in. All the palette knife, as I usually do, have been doing. I think about painting with the palette knife every painting. Get a lot of practice, you get pretty good at it after a while. It's a little bit of a difficult tool to use, but you use it all the time, get a lot of practice. Flat down. More burnt umber, more black. Trying to keep my hand out of the way as much as I can. Come this way. down. He's trying to get a good shape to this opening. Kind of flat on the bottom there. More color and go into some black and burnt umber and come along here and form that edge there on the right. I'm kind of varying it so it's not even. There's a little bit of curve to it. A little bit of curve. Pretty good. All right, so we have a pretty good opening there of our tomb. Getting a little bit rounder here on the top. That's when it becomes difficult when you try to paint round things with a square knife. That's a little bit difficult sometimes. All right, so I'll wipe the knife. Now I will sort of jump around here. Maybe I'll paint this stone here that goes in front. You get out some more burnt umber, some raw sienna, burnt sienna, raw sienna, white. I think some raw sienna someplace. I think I have it in here. I'll find it here. Oh, there we go. Alright, so let me just use white and burnt sienna and burnt umber. Hopefully that gives me the right color. And it doesn't have to be perfect, just an artistic representation. White, burnt umber. Oh, that gives me. That's pretty close. It's almost like sandstone. Yep, that's pretty good. A little bit of color in there. I'm just getting the front of the stone put in. Front of the stone, and like I said, it's hard to paint round things with a square knife, but that's what I can do. I don't know, do they have round knives? I'm not sure. Round palette knives. Come up here. Keeping the color pretty light, I can always go in and add dark afterwards. I have the shape here, I need to go around there. And a sandy color. This round here, this edge. And we have an edge over here. I'm trying to add a little burnt umber to it to keep it from getting too warm. Because if I have all burnt sienna, that's gonna warm it up too much. Brew number is a cooling color, that cools the color. I don't want warm colors in this. I think it's supposed to be like a cold tune here. Like that. Alright, so that got that covered pretty good. Now we have a lot of area up here. We take some white, the same color I was using, but add some gray to it. Some grayishness color and start to. That's a little bit too dark. A little bit more white, a little bit more gray together. And get it covered up here. This is the top. This is the front of the tomb. And I know I'm going to need a lot more white, so I'll get some white out. Dark values in there, not mixing it up too much. And the reference is some green in there too. Start to put that in there a little. A little bit of yellow ochre. I'll turn it a little bit green. Some moss growing in there. A little bit of the yellow ochre with the black. This hint of green, not too much. Some white, some gray. And some more white. There's a lot of paint on there. Here I have it all, add a little bit more for a number to it. It's going to be light enough to stand out from what's going to be here. A little bit more white there. See if I can go this way. It's going to take a lot of weight. There's a lot of paint on here. There's a lot of texture. Oops. Paint on the top there. Gray color to paint in the left side. And if you want to extend it a little, you can go sideways. I'm gonna get some of this paint off my hand before I get it all over the place. I'm not going to put in too many details yet. I'm just sort of underpainting. Overlap of the edge of that opening is. So I'm kind of going over that a little. Going this way. Darker down here. We have these stone shapes. One thing when you put the one thing I do wrong a lot. See how I get some black on my finger? If you hold it too flat, then you end up touching your painting. So just hold it flat, but not too flat. Distinctly in front of that edge there. Pull it down. Oops. See if I can get that painted in there at the bottom. I'm just going to fill it in pretty much without putting too many of those rugged details for now. If I can go this way and get it a little better angle at it. There we go. This is moving around on me a lot, isn't it? Let me sort of go this way. Just do whatever you have to do, really. I just want to put it in that direction. Nobody will know when you're showing the finished painting, right? So we have our tomb, we have our opening, we have the stone that's in front. There's gonna be some stones over here. And just keep going until we get there. So let's see if I can get some paint in front of that there. Oops. Good. Oops. I'm getting paint all over myself, so I think I'll stop now, and that'll be part one. Part two will be to finish painting in the underpainting, and part three will be to detail the little rocks and whatnot in here, and look like an empty tomb back in there. So I hope you guys enjoyed this one, and I'll be back for the next one. Thanks for watching.